Alright guys, so here we are today on the project. It's a couple of days before Christmas weekend. We got basically a 2 acre track here. Right there. Go through it. A little bit behind the machine there. Excuse me, in front of the machine. So mainly we're gonna get rid of everything that's in the area right here in the field. It's gonna be a house. So we're going to get rid of all the small brush and rub it up. And then we're going to just continue on with all the brush there. Quick update. RT-135 is 300 hours on it now. Just a few little minor things on it, but never lost any production with it. So far it's it's a beast. Love the room, love the visibility. Can't say anything negative on Pecan. We love them. So continue on with our Pecan. Production out of that Pecan here. We love it. So we normally don't do this chop method, but we're doing it because we have a couple things. We don't know what's all in here, so sometimes it'll help us see the bottom as we start mulching. And we got quite a few 4 or 5 inch trees in here, like the one we're taking down now. So easier to do that and trying to push it over, because every one of them about 25, 30 feet tall. So, you can see it's like this. Somewhat of a, what we call a sandy loam soil here on this property. It kind of ruts up a little bit, but we just got a couple inches of rain about 3 or 4 days ago, so it's not as dusty as I thought it might be. Big, large mesquite tree. Yes, like an ash tree, and just ran in there and just pushed it straight down, and most of the bottom, it was just pretty much a tail back on it. There's the trees behind it, so that's why we're employing this little chop method. You tilt the head the right way, the material doesn't come back on you. It's just, knowing how to, hold the head and good stay consistently the way you tilt it. Really helps out throwing the debris back into the windshield or underneath the arm. About 5 inches in diameter there, that's not too big, but, you know, no problem for that big bone. When you get the inertia up to speed and going good, I mean, that thing can take down some trees, man. Here's a mesquite tree. It has a hackberry growing into it. Always good to work in, clean your area up and do a little bit at a time. Then you roll up on the bigger pieces that you take down and get tangled up in the traps and police the area around the tree that you cut down. It's always it's a good technique. Just don't bulldog your way back up in there. I got stuff all rolled up on you, you know. So. Well, this is nice and fine, you see. There was about 8-9 inches down. Good sharp T-shirts too. Guys have enough tools in their truck, T-sharp. Helps out the strain on the engine. Piece of material. It's kind of small where it breaks down. Good for the client over time. right, guys, well, about 10 minutes of video there. I'm going to catch some more video here a little bit. It's about 37 degrees here this morning. It's about 7:45 in the morning in Texas. West side of Fort Worth. This is our stomping ground. Guess you're feeling it. Pretty good sized hackberry there. Trying to clean up the area here. Yeah, you can take that old hackberry down. That's a good 8-9 here from the line that we're on that one. Great equipment if you just keep it up, keep it clean. Simple things, just treating it right. All right, guys, I'm gonna catch some more video here shortly.